Good morning students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. Okay students, we have completed 4 lessons in accountancy. Okay, so the 5th lesson I am going to teach you, that third step in accounting. Okay, process of accounting, this is the third step. First one is what? One is preparing journal entries, isn't it? Journal. Second process, preparing ledger accounts. So now the third one is preparing trial balance. Okay, this trial balance. So what is a trial balance? You can say it is a statement. Okay. Statement showing all the balances of ledger accounts. All balances of all ledger accounts. Okay. Ledger accounts, we know that it balance brought down. We have written one thing, isn't it? There, some may be having debit balance. Okay, debit balance, other will have credit balance. Okay, here means two balance brought down, they will write. Two balance brought down means debit balance. Here, by balance brought down, they all credit balances. Okay. So, it is a statement showing all the balances of all ledger accounts. Okay, prepared in the ledger account. Okay, ledger accounts, we have maintained many ledger accounts. All the that balances of all the ledger account will be shown in a statement. That statement is called trial balance. Okay, the format we will write. Okay, the format. First one, name of account. First one, serial number. One, how many account name? Okay, 1, 2, 3, like that. Then next one, name of account. Okay, then debit credit. Debit credit. DRCR also we can write. Okay. This is the format of ledger account. Okay, here's the... They will show the LF also, ledger number. Okay, ledger where it is written. That ledger number also we will write. So, 5 accounts. Name of, serial number, name of account, ledger page number, then debit, credit. Okay. So, here we will write one by one after other. All the accounts we will write. Around 20 accounts they may come. It may come. Okay, we will write everything. We will write either debit or credit. Okay. Like that we will write. Then we will add these two. Okay. For example, if we get here 1 lakh. Credit side also we should get 1 lakh. Okay. Then we can conclude the arithmetical accuracy. Arithmetical accuracy of the books of accounts. Are correct. We can have a conclusion. That means if the total of the debit tally with the total of the credit, then we can assume that arithmetical accuracy is correct. Okay, is maintained. We can conclude. So now I will explain what all the things should be debited and what all the things should be credited. Okay, all the assets, okay, should be on the debit side. We have to write, for example, furniture, debit here. Okay, all the assets will be debited. Then all the liabilities will be credited. Okay, then purchases, debit. So, sales will be credited. In the journal entry also, when we purchase asset, we will debit. Okay. Then when we purchase goods, we will debit purchases. So, debit purchases, credit sales. When all expenses and loss will be debited. So, what will be credited? All income and gain will be credited. Okay. If purchases debited, purchase returns will be credited, or return outward will be credited. Here sales return, sorry, not purchase return, here sales return will be debited, purchase return will be credited. Okay, here sales credited, sales return debited. Purchases debited, purchase returns credited. Okay, only you should write whether it is debit or credit, you have to learn. That's all. Okay, it's very easy chapter. Within one day we can learn, one period we can complete if you do all as homework. Okay, very simple one, we can complete. Now why we are preparing this one, what is the need for preparing the trial balance? Okay, the first one is to check the arithmetical accuracy. Okay, that is the main purpose. That means the calculations, okay, the journal entries, the amount written in the journal entries, then posting in the ledger account, then totaling of ledger account, okay, then balancing of ledger account, then carrying forward from one page to another, if we write correctly, okay, carry it forward, that is correct, or carrying forward the total, that writing the from the ledger account balances in the trial balance, writing in the trial balance, everything is correct, we can conclude. That is the main purpose. Okay, then if there is any error, that is the second purpose, that can be detected, that can be rectified. If there is an error, okay, we have to locate the error first, the detect, find out or locate the error first, then if there is an error, how to rectify that error. Okay, so in order to rectify an error, in order to locate and rectify an error, this preparation of trial balance helps a lot. Why? If the total is different, okay, if the total of the debit and credit are different, then we can say some mistake somewhere has been made. Okay, so that has to be located and that has to be rectified. Okay, then with this one only they will prepare the final accounts. That is the main purpose. Okay, in order to prepare the final account, we know trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet. Okay, so in order to prepare, in order to maintain the final accounts, preparation of final accounts, this preparation of trial balance is very essential. Okay, there is one definition given. Okay, trial balance is a statement prepared with the debit and credit balances. Okay, that you can read and learn. Okay, now we will learn the features. What are the features of trial balances? Okay, what are the features of trial balance? So first we can say it contains all ledger accounts, details of all the balances of ledger account. Sorry, balances of all ledger accounts. Okay, that is the main feature. Then it is prepared on a date, on a particular date. We never write for the year ending, no. We will write trial balance as on. Maybe on a particular date we can say, maybe on the end of financial year, okay, as on 31st December 2019. Okay, so we can say it is prepared on a particular date. Either it may be prepared monthly or, okay, then maybe for 2 months, 3 months, quarterly or half yearly, okay, or 1 year, annually. Okay, once. Then as we have learnt in the need, it is prepared in order to help the, in order to check the arithmetical accuracy of accounts, books of accounts. Arithmetical accuracy. Entries made in the books of accounts. Okay, in order to check the arithmetical accuracy of entries made in the books of accounts, that is another feature. Okay, then if there is any difference, okay, if it is equal, we can say there is no error, isn't it? If there is any difference, then we can say there is an error. Then that error must be located. Then what they have to do? They have to rectify. Sometimes some error may not be shown in the trial balance. Okay, some errors will not be disclosed. Here some errors, for example, we will learn this one. Okay, error, one lesson itself there. Okay, location of errors. Errors cannot be located. Okay, cannot be located. What are those errors? They are error of principle. Principle means the rule when we apply. Capital nature will be entered as revenue nature. There it will not show in the error. Okay. It will not show in the trial balance. Okay, trial balance will get tally. So we cannot say that there is no error. There will be error. For example, if we make any principle, error of principle, or some compensating error, one error will be compensated by another error. Okay. This one cannot be located. Okay, then any transaction is omitted, that is error of omission. Completely omitted one journal entry, then it will not, if we don't post that journal entry anywhere, journal entry is as it is, we did not post in the ledger account, it will not show. The trial balance will get tally. Okay. So these are the features. Then same that next heading, objectives. This also as like features only. Okay. What are the main purpose? Main purpose is testing the arithmetical accuracy. Trial balance, if we say, this word only has to come. Okay. Test of arithmetical accuracy. Okay. Well, trial balance is mainly prepared in order to check the arithmetical accuracy. That addition, subtraction, everything is correct. What we have added. Okay. What we have written is correct. We can conclude. Okay, everywhere that we have made correctly, that's, we can say, okay, it is correct. And the next one, this is the basis for the preparation of final accounts. Okay, in the meaning there itself we have learned in the need. Okay, this is considered as the basis. From the trial balance only we will prepare the final account, trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet. Okay, then location of error, next objective. Error can be located. Okay, error can be located. When we can say there is an error, if the trial balance does not tally, we can say there are some errors have occurred. Okay, so errors can take place at any stage. Maybe at the time of making journal entries. Okay. The wrong amount can be written, one debit to one amount, credit to one amount, okay, in the journal entry. Or when we do posting, then we have learned here, no, at the time of addition, okay, totaling or balancing or carrying forward the amount from the trial, from the ledger account to the trial balance, okay, at any stage any error can be made. Okay, so the main objective is what? These errors can be located and it can be rectified. okay, then summarized the information of ledger accounts. Summarized the information of ledger accounts. Here it is like a summary or statement. We have learned, no? All the ledger balances, okay, will be given in one page. Okay, well, how much is the total purchases of that year? What is the total of sales account balance? Okay, then what is the total of the wages that year that we have paid? Okay, so it is serving as the summary information, summarized information of ledger account. Okay, then some limitations are also there of trial balance. What is the limitation? It has many objectives, many merits. Okay, many are there, but some limitations are also there. Okay, so if that organization follow double entry system, only then we can prepare the ledger account and we can locate the error. Okay, then another limitation, if some transactions are omitted, then the trial balance will get tally. Okay, the trial balance will get tally. So there itself in the some the transaction they didn't prepare journal entries, okay, but that error cannot be located from the ledger account, this trial balance. Okay, now some errors will be there, but it will get to tally. Okay, that is another problem. Okay, some transaction will be omitted, but it will get tally. Even though some errors are there, it will get tally. Okay, then if the trial balance is not prepared in a systematic way correctly, then the final accounts will not show the correct or true and fair view of the financial position of the business. Fair view of the business cannot be seen. Okay, then simply we cannot conclude, okay, trial balance get tally, okay, everything is correct, we cannot say. Okay, because some errors are there. Okay, some errors that cannot be shown, that cannot be located. Okay, the trial balance will not show some of the errors, the error of principle, error of omission, error compensating errors. So these errors cannot be seen, cannot be understood if the trial balance get tally. That is also another drawback. Okay, up to this we have learned. I will mark and give in the Zoom class. Okay, thank you, students.